Another one by Namdeo Dasal. It's from his poem called Gandu Bagicha, published in 1986. It's translated as Arse Fuckers Park. It's only one of the sections that I'm gonna read. There are neither flowers nor leaves, neither trees nor birds. All this is mimicry by mercy of His grace, sealed fragrance of musk. Thus the chains on one's legs are transformed into music. O revealed friend, O gardener, what shall I recall? Tears flood the soil of your sensibility in the morning and in the evening on your sterile field of silence. Home guards perform their drill. On some festive day, a pederast politician, a counselor, preaches here. The dancing water pot of goddesses Yalama and an All India Women's Conference, pimps confessing to a study of group of streetwalkers. Politicized crows listening to the proceedings, chorus smokers, ganja smokers, pickpockets and thieves, a mottled forest in the hot, hot, oh, arse fuckers park. What sad hour you've chosen to strike at my roots, praise and curse, arousal in ears, an eternity of darkness lined by a golden shore. The delusion, all hell breaking loose in diamond garlands, the stigma of concealed love and the harried soul, the inferno of lovers' separation and the graveyard of compassion, extreme loneliness and the magic of the frightened. Behind every word, there's a naked face hidden. How can I yoke these slaves of the bed to my plough, arse fuckers, park? Your city of insatiable angels, I bear a crown of agony on my head. I bear a crown of agony on my head, a luminous fountain of African anguish. A wound has found its home in my heart. Even words cannot open its doors. A wound has found its home in my heart. Even words cannot open its doors. A bear made of sunbeams is walking around with a banner. No complaint can be registered here. A wretched derelict of a poet like me starts dancing to corrupted words in a saint's festival. There are neither slogans nor shrieks of pain. Every face of compassion wears a black veil. You are allowing your downtrodden life to swim in the hell water of self-alienation. What more can even the trees do now except scratch the armpits of bygone times? What more can even the trees do now except scratch the armpits of bygone times? Let me fill into my eyes the darkness in the womb of the soil. Allow me to listen to the counterfeit jingle of the coin of my distraught, sleek-necked dreams. Allow me just once to plaster the cracks in the city of contemporary anguish. Wearing a white shroud of formless silence sleeps in your courtyard. And the sarcastic scrawl of the bleeding piles in the alphabetical chart swells up. A mottled piglet tries to fondle grass, the impotence inherent in good and evil, the supernatural finger caressing tresses of hair. Female buffaloes of a high-yielding breed go on a rampage in midnight's outburst of ejaculations. The master physicians handling them find themselves paralyzed in a hall of mirrors. There's a chaos of mocking reflections. How many images of oneself can one see? How many images of oneself can one see? Horses are being tattooed on my arms. The creeping plant of my penis is about to flower. Ibsen's doll is about to get married. All this pining is to get out of this circular battle trap. The black truth seeks to ride the tortoise. I see you on your moral path with the cataracts and the tear pills in your anguished eyes. After that, I remember your silent lips, the distressed insect of your distorted body getting its wings painted. The owl in the hollow of a tree intones its drone. And you refuse to open the door of your perception. Shall I now put on the boot of amazement on my lame foot? Shall I now bell the cat? Or shall I scrape off this intolerable grotesquerie? Shall I put out the flame that glows? Shall I put out the flame that glows between the beginning and the end?